grand final day here at Hertfordshire Sports Village, and it looks pretty quiet out here at the moment, but it's a different story inside. Come and have a look.
What do you think of the game so far, girls?
It's real.
And it's been a bit stressful, to be honest. Maggie Jackson has been livid. She's been pointing her finger mainly at the defence, I have to say.
1, 2, 3. It's grand final day here at Hertfordshire Sports Village, and it looks pretty quiet out here at the moment, but it's a different story inside. Come and have a look. There, but we're here in the changing rooms. We've been given special access, and I'm here with ex-Maverick Amanda. Now, Amanda, tell us, what's the atmosphere going to be like in here before the match?
I'm sure the girls are very nervous, and there's going to be lots of tense girls playing today, but I think it's going to be good. It's going to be good for netball, and it's a live game, so what more could you ask for?
Right, I can see you're busy. I'll let you get on with your preparation. So after all the team talk and the hype in here, it's out to the court. So this is the route that both teams are going to take. Once they've had their team talks in the changing rooms, they're going to be in the zone by the sounds of it. They're going to walk out onto the court here. It's a sell-out crowd tonight, so the atmosphere is going to be immense. But for that, we need some fans.
Go, Mavericks!
So who are you here to support tonight?
Obviously, Surrey Storm. I really hope they win. We're here to support Gemma Cosentino. She's my sister, so I really hope they win.
Well, obviously Mavericks, I mean, that's why we're here. They've done so brilliantly this season, and it's going to be a really, really good game, but go Mavericks, that's what we think.
What score are you predicting tonight?
50-45 to Storm.
So the fans are starting to take their seats now. There's a few warm-up games going on just to whet their appetite, but all we can do now is wait for the main
Sarah
event.
Cooper is down courtside, I believe. You're by the Dragons bench, Sarah.
That's right, and coach Melissa Hyman just focusing here on maintaining the work of these first two quarters. She's happy with her attack. She hasn't been saying too much to them. The goals keep going in, and Wildcats just no match for them at the moment. But defensively, I've just overheard her. She still wants more from her defence. She wants them to lock down on the likes of Leslie McDonald. She doesn't want them to be conceding any more goals now. She wants to just stay ahead and really make this a convincing win tonight, perhaps to send a message to Surrey Storm, who, of course, will stand in the way of their playoff hopes later on. So we'll see what they bring out in the next quarter, but certainly some more work for the defence from Hyman here. Back to you.
And now Sarah Cooper is courtside with some of your emails. Sarah.
That's right. We've had lots of emails from all you excited fans out there tonight. Let's start with one from Nikki Everett. Now, she supports Mavericks and normally watches with her mum. She's enjoying all the action today after finishing an exam earlier, so that's a good way for her to celebrate tonight. Victoria Wills has also been in touch. Now, she's actually a Team Bath fan who's supporting Mavericks tonight. It's because she tells us she loves watching Sasha Corbin play, and I don't think she's alone there. And Josh Rudd sent us an email as well. He's from Dartwood. He's watching and supporting Georgia Schmidt, who just so happens to be his PE teacher as well. Keep them coming. Back to you, Ingrid.
Here we are at Sheffield train station. Now, this is where we think the Queen will be arriving a bit later on. We think that she'll be travelling in her own private train. We can't tell you any details about timings yet, about when she'll get here, because it's all top secret at the moment. But I will tell you what I do know. Come and follow me. So details are a bit sketchy at the moment about how the Queen's going to be escorted from the train station to her first stop. She might get a taxi, might get the bus, might get the tram. You might spot her, so keep your eyes peeled. Anyway, we do know where her first stop actually is. It's a new department opening at the University of Sheffield. It's like the only one in Europe, so it's pretty exciting stuff. I'm going to head over there now.
Thanks, Ingrid. Well, there certainly have been a few shock results recently. Anita, let's start off with that Team Northumbria match. Talk us through that one.
Well, I think it's just credit to Tracy and the Team Northumbria squad. They've been working all season. A slightly freak result, but Team Northumbria knew it was coming just with the depth that they've got now and working with the young players, as Tracy's done for so long through this season.
And it just shows, doesn't it, how reliant the top teams have become on their international players, because without them, the league's pretty much level, isn't it?
Yes, and just two players made a difference, or did it make the difference? Question to be asked there, but at least for a developing franchise, it's credit to know that the coaching structure's working and the tactics are being employed on court by those players. So credit to Team Northumbria, well deserved, and those girls are really on a high at the moment after that.
Now, what was the bigger surprise for you? Was it Surrey Storm's loss, or was it that Team Bath near miss?
I would expect Surrey Storm to have probably contested to a closer result, definitely. They've got players with experience. Interesting that Gemma Wiseman's played goal attack for the majority of the season, turned out at wing attack, which for me, that made a difference in my perspective. But yeah, who knows?
Now, we've got a couple of crucial games coming up in terms of getting through to the playoffs. What should we be looking out for?
I think there's two crucial fixtures, really. Certainly Surrey Storm v Celtic. Should Celtic get a victory over Surrey Storm, then it does give Loughborough a chance, probably on goal difference, to try and make the fourth spot playoff. The second fixture is Monday with Thunder and Bath as well. So that will be a contest for first place if Bath can make it, Thunder can make it.
Right, well, certainly still a lot to play for out on court tonight. Back to you, Ingrid.